Hey everyone, welcome back to Music Theory for Beginners. My name is William, and today we will be talking about symbol and compound meters. In our past videos, we mostly focus on rhythms in which their beats can be divided by 2 or a multiple of 2. Examples of these are like 4-4, 3-4, and 2-4. In all of these time signatures, the beats are often divided into 8th notes or 16th notes. These can be called simple meters. Let's look at the 3-4 one in more detail. So here is a 3-4 time signature with 2 measures. Just to review, you can determine the amount of beats in each measure with this top number. Since it's a 3, we know that there is 1, 2, 3 beats in one measure of the 3-4 time. With the bottom note, we can then determine which note gets the beat. For example, since it's a 4, we know that a quarter note gets the beat. So that is why there are 3 quarter notes in this 3-4 time signature. Since a 3-4 is considered a simple meter, that means its beats can be subdivided into smaller intervals of 2. See, with this example, each beat, 2, 3, can be separated into 2 8th notes, resulting with 6 8th notes. However, there are more than just simple meters. There are such things called compound meters. Compound meters are meters that divide its beat into 3 equal parts. Some of these meters can include the 3-8, the 6-8, and the 9-8. Let's look at the 6-8 one in more detail. With the 6-8 time signature, we can tell that there are 6 beats in a measure with this number, 6. We can tell which note gets the beat with this 8, which means the 8th note gets the beat. However, in the 6-8 measure, people do not place emphasis on every single 8th note. What they like to do is they like to split the 6-8 into 2 beats, 1, 2. Often 1.5 beats each. Therefore, being 3 subdivisions in each beat, this can be considered a compound meter because it is mostly divided into 3 different notes. Next, we will cover tuplets again. In the note value video we did, we covered a bit of tuplets, but we will review that just in case if you missed the video. So a tuplet is basically a group of notes, sort of similar to 8th notes, but what happens is they notate a certain number on top, so that number notates how many subdivisions there are in one beat. For example, in this triplet, in this one beat, you would play 3 notes. And also in this quintuplet, in this one beat, you would play 5 notes. So this number can be pretty much anything. It can be 3, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever number you want. But there is one rule of thumb to follow. These tuplets should be only used when rhythm is outside of its typical meter. For example, in a 2-4 time signature, you typically would only see 8th notes, 16th notes, 32nd notes. You would not see a beat being divided up into 3 notes. Therefore, we must use triplets to notate that this is out of the ordinary and should be divided into 3 notes. Same thing with compound meters. Normally in 6-8, you would divide each beat up into 3. However, if you wanted to divide it up into 2, then you would have to notate it with this 2, so that people would understand that each 6-8 beat would have to be divided into 2 beats. That is it for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope that you all learned something about simple and compound meters in this video. If you ever have any questions at all, do not hesitate to ask us in the comment section. Also, if you have any other ideas for videos, feel free to suggest them in the comment section too. Thank you guys for watching, and we will see you soon.